It's the birth of a new club as we're underway in Draft Champions. This is taken at the three. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And nothing doing on his first run. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Paul Kruger there to bring him down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that total. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up the defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
Mariota flushed out right. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Call it a gain of five. And that's going to lead to a third down.
You know, I don't think this is the last time we'll see that in this game. This guy has mobility, and they want to use his legs in the game plan. So there'll be design runs as well as his scrambles.
Here's Elliott, and he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
It comes, and he lost the football. Mariota had it jarred loose. And some room to maneuver. Past the 20. And this is going to be brought back for a fumble return touchdown by the Cowboys. And give some kudos to the defensive coordinator, I think, here. They bring the blitz, they dial it up, and it turns into 6 points for them.
It's so nice to hear you actually give kudos to the defense. It is so nice to such an offensive guy like that. I love it. He dialed things up, and boy, a big play resulted for his guys.
Well, you like the credit to the defense there, right, my friend?
Yeah, do I ever.
So a big play there, not only the fumble return for the touchdown, then they get the two-point try. And, you know, for the defense, though, they were just over there sitting on the field. They had to rush out to try to defend that.
You know, it's funny. They actually practice situations that they call sudden change when the team turns it over. I guarantee you no one practices a fumble return for a touchdown like that, and now someone goes for two. Really good strategy by them putting them in that situation.
The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. First down, Mariota. And a catch made by Kenny Britt. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. And give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
That was a nicely run slant route. And what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target. When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that is what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
A gain of 32 that time. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. A first down carry by Elliott. Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number two. They've got a second down at 5 here to start things out. Again, it's Elliott. Oh, the hurdle. And he's brought down. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal.
We really didn't have any doubt that he was going to be one of the top-rated rookies coming into the league, especially as a runner. And he's given us no reason to change our minds.
And he's across the chalk, into the end zone, touchdown Seahawks. Ezekiel Elliott taking it in. And the Seahawks, a two-point conversion away from tying the game. Mariota will look to throw. Flush to his right. And he'll get in to tie this game at 8. Well, it's definitely early enough here. They didn't need to go for 2. They didn't have to go for 2, but hey, they did. We're all tied at 8.
Is this one of those anything you can do, I can match? Because that's exactly what we got on that one. Neither one of these teams wants to give any ground, do they?
They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. And he fends him off. And he will not get away from the pressure here. Carr taken down. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
Throwing now is Carr, being chased out left. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side. The tight end, Jeremy Shockey, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
That's a bold strike right there, taking it downfield and putting some air on it. But how about the coverage? Able to get his hands across the receiver and bat the ball down.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. NFL teams last year, a little under 50% on fourth down conversions. This is a bit tougher. Fourth and 4. Now Carr finds his target, Montgomery. Give him 8 on the play, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation.
And now the ball's out. Carr lost it. Fumble. Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually challenge the play or not. In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. You throw that flag, you probably feel really confident, and then all of a sudden, boom, you lose the challenge.
Yeah, when you take a look at it, you're throwing that flag because you believe you're going to be right. And when it comes back the other way, you have to regroup.
And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the red zone of the chalk of the 20. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. Into the red zone, it's Carr. And this one is incomplete. He was looking for Ty Montgomery that time. And that'll bring up second down. Carr will try it again on second down. Trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Give them 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open. So it was tucking in run time, and he picks up a first down.
Now he'll let it go deep right side. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, Your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Right back for Marshall. This time it's complete. A really nice gain of 25 yards. And the young buck showing that ability, that agility to dance outside of the pocket, complete the deep ball.
And don't think for a second that the coaching staff didn't have their heart rate accelerate a little bit there, right? Anytime you have those young quarterbacks and they get outside of the pocket, you're just hoping that they make good decisions because so many things can happen that can go wrong when you throw it downfield like that. He got away with it there and in a big way.
Mariota on first down. Steps away to his left. And he'll just chuck this one up into row G. It's incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Third and long here for Mariota. Buying time to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep left side. He was looking to get it to Kenny Britt that time. And now it's fourth down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Now Mariota on fourth down. Looking for Britt. Intercepted. And nothing but green grass here. Middle of the field. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. So they go on fourth down. Not only do they not get it, it turns into 6 points the other way. Disastrous.
And many people think you should just go ahead and knock it down in that situation. Turn it over for the offense. But I had a defensive coordinator recently tell me, we see that as a passive play. We don't do that anymore. We want the ball in our hands, and we want to head the other way.
Probably also instinct a lot of times. If you see a lot of green grass ahead of you, go ahead and grab it.
It's the exact right play to do. That's knowing when to break the rules and when to make a play that maybe you hadn't been taught.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now he'll throw deep left side. It's caught inside the 25. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
So they get the score with a clock at all zeros. Now, are they gutsy here in the second quarter and go for two?
I think they go ahead and kick the ball through the post. Down one at that stage. Yeah, I know. No guts, no glory, right? But I think they kick it through the post. They'll feel like they're tied. They'll feel like it's an even game.
And he's got it. So they get the two-point conversion, and with that, this game suddenly tied as we reach the end of the first half. And how about this right out of the locker room, an onside kick attempt. And the Cowboys are able to recover. A tie game. I don't think anybody in this building, including you or I, was expecting that.
No, I would agree with that totally. I didn't expect to see it at all, but I kind of like where they were going with this. You know, as you said, tie game, trying to steal a possession, steal an advantage, and you told your defense at the half you were going to do it, which also told them that you had confidence in them in case it failed, as that one just did.
And now you've given good field position here to start the third quarter. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Carr to throw on second down. Bryant with a catch right side. They lost four there, and it's third down.
They completed the screen on the perimeter, but boy, that was textbook defense. Exactly as you're taught to play against a wide receiver screen, and they snuffed it out for a loss of yardage.
On third and long, it's Carr. Pressure comes, he's taken down by the Seahawk defense. Terrell McClain in there to get him for a loss of nine. And that'll lead to fourth down. Pulled in at the 24. That'll be a 43-yard punt, but an end of just 33 following a 10-yard return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out to their first possession of the second half. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You've got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan is showing you.
The new acquisition, Martellus Bennett, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
It's nothing like pressure to affect the accuracy and the timing of a guy trying to throw the football. And on that play, they ended up flushing him to his left, contacted him as he's trying to throw the football, and that led to the incompletion.
And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of four. Now third down.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL, and a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses, and now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
Now the offense lining up first and 10.
On third down, the defense decided to blitz. A very good job of recognizing it, stepping away from the pressure, and finding open space to scramble and pick up a first down.
And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it. Incomplete.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually it was. There's a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ike's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Well, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile with their feet. He showed the agility there with a toe tap.
No doubt about it. It's like he'd went to ballet school. Got the toes down and stayed in bounds. But forget knowing where the first down line was. This defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front. A lot of times that is one-on-one. If you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They had more people to the football and snuffed out the play.
And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. On second down, here's Carr sliding out of the pocket. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. They get nine out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Back now in Nashville, all even as we get ready to start the fourth. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. On first and 10, here's Carr. Room here to run. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. They'll give him eight on the play, and it'll be a second down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Now they'll throw with Carr. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
Carr now on first down. This is Montgomery with a grab over the middle. Give him 13 on the pickup there. And it'll be first down, Cowboys. Simple slant route and part of a really nice hard throw by the quarterback.
Nice timing between the quarterback and the receiver. They were perfectly in sync, and he put it right on him on the inside route.
All day, all day, all day. On first down, Carr dumps off to Helu. Touchdown, Cowboys! Roy Helu, 38 yards. And the Cowboys have broken the tie. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover him? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. And Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. A second down throw here for Mariota. And over the middle to the tight end, Bennett. And he's able to get up here to the 26. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. And if the defense can hold here, this ball game is over.
And they're thinking more than just holding. They're thinking about a takeaway to finish things off.
Now Elliott, and he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
Eluding the pressure right. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. It's the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu. And he returns it here to his own 18-yard line. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but it's still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet. Carr going to look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And now the ball's out. Carr lost it. Fumble. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. He's back to throw. Flushed out right. He's going to let it fly. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down.
When teams take shots at the end zone, you've got to defend it the same way you would defend the first down sticks. You defend the goal line exactly the same way. They can't cross that. You play through the receivers. Now, on that play, that's exactly what they did and batted it away.
Back to throw. Steps away. And he'll just throw this one over in the way of the security crew. Incomplete here. They got pressure there and only rushing three.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with three there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You drop an eight. Where are you going to go with the football?
Back to throw. And he's got Bennett. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes this one down to the 15. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter play. They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. A dump off to Elliott. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that'll make it second down.
It didn't check off every box, but the most important one. Got the clock stopped, getting out of bounds. They may be a little short of the first down, but I thought that was the key.
He'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he is in as they have tied it late here in the final minute of the fourth quarter.
And now we get a tie game after that touchdown. And you and I both know what that means. extra point. In this situation, this little time left takes on some extra emphasis, doesn't it?
It does indeed. Now inside the final minute, can they get it and hold on? And they have taken the lead here in this fourth quarter. The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field, and we are ready to rock. This will be taken very short. So out come the Cowboys now as their offense gets set to take over. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. To throw his car. And he's got Edelman for the first time. That's complete. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Back to throw, Carr. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety. Thank you.